horrific video catches what three racist black nurses did to dying World War II vet as they laughed. Thanks to the former President Barack Hussein Obama and his manufactured race war, racial tensions in our country are now at an all-time high. But now the so-called race wars have reached a new all-time low after a video popped up online which appears to show a horrible act of racism in a nursing home. It's unbelievable what a group of three black nurses did to a dying white World War II veteran who was screaming in agony from the confines of his nursing home bed. Thanks to the former President Barack Hussein Obama and his manufactured race war, racial tensions in our country are now at an all-time high. But now the so-called race wars have reached a new all-time low after a video popped up online which appears to show a horrible act of racism in a nursing home. It's unbelievable what a group of three black nurses did to a dying white World War II veteran who was screaming in agony from the confines of his nursing home bed. During questioning, Knuckles simply passed off the entire incident as an honest mistake after being caught red-handed in a lie after being confronted with the video footage. "I was just basing everything on what I normally do." "Doing what you normally do? Is laughing while World War II veterans die what you normally do, Wanda Knuckles?" Not only did she lie about the chest compressions, the staff did not call 911 until an hour later. When nurses had difficulty getting Dempsey's oxygen machine operational during attempts to fix the issue, you can hear Knuckles and others laughing, Popular Military reported. Retired nursing professional Elaine Harris reviewed the footage and still cannot get over the horror of what she witnessed. "In 43 years in nursing, I have never seen such disregard for human life in a healthcare setting, is what I witnessed," Harris said. Harris went on to criticize the nursing staff, claiming that the nurses failed to respond, assess and act, not to mention the failure to continuously perform CPR, Popular Military went on. "That is absolutely inappropriate. You never stop compressions," said concluded. What's even more startling is that the Atlanta nursing home tried to bury the story from being leaked to the public. But due to the incredible perseverance of the local news outlet 11 Alive, these women will forever be shamed. Attorneys representing the Atlanta nursing home tried to prevent 11 Alive from obtaining the video. They asked a DeKalb County judge to keep the video sealed and then attempted to appeal to the Georgia State Supreme Court. The judge ruled in favor of 11 Alive and the nursing home eventually dropped its appeal to the state's highest court, 11 Alive reported. Investigator Stephen Haley pointed out that criminal charges need to be immediately pressed against these three individuals and that it's ridiculous that the only punishment they've received is simply losing their jobs as nurses. On top of that, how these nurses acted wasn't even normal human behavior, Haley stated. "On a human level, how could you possibly do that?" Stephen began. "I might not like some of the protesters, but if I saw someone dying on the street, suffering in pain, calling out for help, I'd help them. It's just a part of being human. But somehow these nurses don't even have that compassion for a World War II veteran, who's dying in pain. How did they get to be nurses?" James Dempsey died at the age of 89. He was a decorated World War II veteran from Woodstock, Georgia. He served his country with honor in the time of its greatest need. God bless his soul. "I'm so sorry you were treated this way," Stephen concluded. 11 Alive reports that Dempsey's family have reached a settlement agreement with Sava Senior Care, who fired 10 of the nurses involved after the video was brought to their attention. Horrifyingly, this isn't the first time that Northeast Atlanta Health and Rehabilitation has abused patients, as they continued to have a history of abuse after Dempsey's death due to health and safety violations. They've been given a one-star rating from Medicare, and have also been smacked with $813,113 in fines since 2015. "These savage scumbag nurses called this sick incident where a man died an honest mistake? Are you freaking kidding? A man died desperately gasping for air and they laughed hysterically? How is this considered an honest mistake? This has to be the sickest display of racism I have ever witnessed in my lifetime. Nurses take an oath to do good and help people. These three characters decided to ignore a man who was a World War II hero because they are a bunch of racists who hate white people, plain and simple. These sorts of acts were unheard of before the presidency of Barack Hussein Obama, who won only because white liberals in this country suffer from an acute condition of white guilt. White guilt.